Are we ready? Okay, perfect. Well, welcome. I'm so glad that you guys are here. My name is Teresa. I think I met both you guys, but and I have the pleasure of being here today to talk to you guys about thankfulness. So I have a little bit to share with you guys, and then we are going to see if we can pray with you guys and just get to know you a little bit. Okay, so I added this first scripture in here, mostly for the parents, just to encourage parents that this is what we're supposed to be doing as parents and as people that are involved in kids' lives, that Proverbs 22:6 says, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it, right? So as parents, that's what we need to be doing. It sums up what our job is. Right, we need to be teaching them, disciplining them, the examples we set, and we know that kids are sponges, right? Especially when they're really little. So we need to be, you guys are doing the right thing by being here and instructing your kids in the Word and teaching them about spiritual warfare. So just to encourage you. So we're going to talk about thankfulness, and this is something that has really been kind of on my heart lately, and I think it's really, really important to just focus on the importance of thankfulness. So I had a scripture on here from Psalm 100, verse 4. It says, enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful to him and bless his name. So anybody here want to share something just before we start that they can think of that they're thankful for? It could be big. It could be little. Anybody want to share? Angela, you want to share? Anything that you might be thankful for? Or maybe Mike. Mike, you want to share?
Just thankful for my family and thankful for my salvation, most of all.
Yeah.
Ditto.
Yeah.
Ditto. I'm thankful to be here.
Family, yeah. Another birthday this year.
Yeah.
We made it another year.
Praise God. Yeah. Yep. So what does the Bible say about thankfulness? Because as Christians, we're always seeking what the Lord says, right? And we want to look to Scripture and the Bible to find out answers, because the Bible is actually a super cool book that really gives us all the answers on how we can live our life and what God wants us to do. So the Bible says to give thanks. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. And that's another psalm. So there's a lot of amazing psalms in the Bible. Thankfulness is our response to who God is. It's our response to his love, his forgiveness, his grace, his mercy. And those are all things, those are all gifts, right? Those are all gifts to us from God. And I want you to think about, so when someone gives you a gift, right, or gives you something, they share something with you, what's our response usually? It's usually, thank you, right? We're grateful, we're thankful. And a lot of times we use those words interchangeably, thankfulness and gratefulness. We'll hear that a lot, but we're thankful, right? Someone holds the door for us. Hopefully we're saying thank you, right? We're thankful for things when people give us things or do things for us. So we can think about, you know, we should be doing that same to God, right? When he's giving us these things, he's giving us another year to have a birthday and giving us breath in our lungs and giving us a home and clothes and food and our toys, our monster trucks, whatever it might be, right? And he loves us. He wants to bless us with good things. So our response, our natural response to God, is to be thankful and show our thankfulness. And it actually says in James 1, verse 17, every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, and it comes down from the Father, right? So all those things are given to us. Even the beautiful plants and the flowers and the scenery, the mountains, the things that we get to experience, those are all from God. Those are gifts. So why? So we know that we should be thankful, right? But why is that actually so important? And the Bible tells us that it's actually God's will for us to be thankful, right? It's His will. That means that's His plan, His purpose for us. That's something that He's expecting for us. And in all circumstances, right? In 1 Thessalonians, it says, rejoice always, pray continually, and give thanks in all circumstances. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you, for you and you and me and all of us, right? And I really like to pay attention to, I underline some things, because when we really stop to think about some of these words like always, continually, that just kind of makes us put a little different spin and think differently, right? It doesn't say, you know, rejoice sometimes when you get your way, or, you know, pray when things are just really bad, or give thanks when someone shares with you or gives you a gift, right? It says always, which includes the times that things are not going well, right? Or that we're not getting what we want. So that's His will. So that's why that's so important. It's a command, right? It's not just a suggestion. God, when we're following the Lord and we're Christians, it's a command from God that we give thanks. I have some notes here, so I just want to make sure I get everything. And did you know, in fact, because it is a command, that if we're not coming to God in thankfulness, and we're not viewing life with thankfulness, it's actually disobedience, right? It's important to give thanks to God when we pray, right? So a lot of times we think of, you know, going to God to pray when we're needing something, right? And that is important. That is what we're supposed to be doing. But when we pray, right, it's a relationship. We're not just going to God to make our requests known and tell Him the list of things that we need. We have a relationship with Him, right? In a relationship, we communicate, we talk, we listen, right? We fellowship, we spend time with one another. And that's what God is expecting of us, right? So we need to go, and just like if we were with a friend or a parent, or a group of our peers, we need to have a relationship and we need to give thanks. So we should, when we are praying, we should be going to God first with thanks, right? We can say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for this, whatever you can come up with. And sometimes we could go very long on giving thanks, right? Because there's so much to be thankful for. But it's important that we start our prayers by acknowledging and giving thanks to God for who He is and what He's doing in our life. In Philippians 4, it says, do not be anxious about anything. Underline some of those again, right? But in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving. So there's that. He's expecting us to come with thanksgiving. Present your request to God. So He cares about our requests, right? He cares about the big things. He cares about the little things. So don't ever forget that either. So He wants to hear our requests, and He wants to answer our prayers. He hears us, but He wants us to be coming with thanks. And you see, the first part, that's a whole nother study, but to not be anxious about anything. Those are really powerful words, aren't they? So sometimes when we think about, you know, things that we're worried about or anxious about, we think, well, maybe we shouldn't be anxious about this test, but hey, we definitely should be anxious about if I'm going to make the team or not, or whatever it might be. But He tells us, don't do that. Don't be anxious about anything. But in every situation, every single time, give thanksgiving and tell God what's going on, right? He hears us. So I know that sounds really easy, right? Makes it sound easy. But sometimes, is it really hard to give thanks? Yeah. Yep. I know I've had times. And it happens. It happens. So, how can we give thanks when bad things are happening? I want to make sure I wrote a couple notes on here. I want to make sure I don't miss it. So when bad things are happening, maybe it's really tough at school, someone's not being very nice, maybe somebody's sick, maybe you're sick, someone's sick in your family, you got left out, maybe you did bad on a test. How do we give thanks for that? What do we do?
I have an idea.
Yeah.
We can go back to the scripture and understand that the various trials that we go through are improving our faith and testing our faith in God.
Yeah, absolutely. So I had down here about faith. So what Erica said is that we can go back, right? We still, what did God command in those scriptures before, right? He said all, so it includes these circumstances. We still need to say thank you, God. And what I think is important for people to understand is we have kind of a joke in our Bible study group. We'll just say, praise God, praise God. And what I think is important for people to understand is that we're not praising God or thanking God that, boy, thank you that we got into this accident. Thank you that I fell and got sick, or thank you that I got into an accident. We're thanking God because He's still with us. He's going to get us through that. And as much as our brains, some of us are really, really, really smart, we still, sometimes we can only see what's in front of us, right? And God sees the big picture, and He can use those things. He's got a plan. And sometimes it's really hard for us to imagine, boy, this feels really icky right now, and how are you going to use this, God? But we know, all of us, I'm sure, can think of times we look back on and we think, whoa, that was your plan. That's how you use this. And we're so thankful. I know I'm thankful. I've had some times in life where I thought, this is really, really heavy stuff, and how am I going to get out of this mess? And when you trust God and give thanks, can look back and think, He used that to help me grow. And like Erica said, and that builds our faith, right? And when we share those testimonies to people around us, that increases their faith too, right? That's why it's so important. That's why He tells us to share those stories and testimonies. So one of my favorite scriptures, Romans 8:28, says that, and we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, right? To those who are called according to His purpose. So that part that says we know that all things, so all these little pieces, all these little messy pieces of things that we experience or hurt, when we're surrendering and we're trusting God, He'll pick up those pieces. He'll somehow put them all back together, right? And the thing that we need to remember, though, is that sometimes it's not the way that we think it's going to look, right? We might have an idea, and God has a much better idea. So we have to trust. Let's see here. Yes. And so we have to remember that God can use things that don't seem good and use them for good. Right? That's His business. That's His specialty, right? Because things happen, and he can use them for the good. He can grow our faith. He can teach us something. He can expose something or show us the way, you know, that we need to do things next time to grow and get better. And when I did this slide, I was thinking about a story in the Bible about Job. Has anybody heard of Job in the Bible? And Job, what happened to Job? Like all these bad things, right? Everything. You ever heard that story? Yeah. Yeah. So Job, I mean, he lost his animals and his family, and he was sick, and he still, he thanked God and he praised God, right? And then what happened at the end? God restored things for him, right? Now, did it mean that Job, that was easy to do? No, he was suffering, right? He was suffering. So sometimes we will suffer, and we'll go through trials, and it's tough. So he doesn't say it's going to be easy. So, but He will restore things, and He'll work them all out for our good. So keep that scripture. That's a really good one to keep in mind.
I have one.
Yeah.
So this morning I was reading in the Bible, and I got led to 1 Peter 1, and this is verse 6. Okay, it says, "You rejoice in this, even though now for a short time, if necessary, you suffer grief in various trials, so that the proven character of your faith, more valuable than gold, which is perishable, is refined by fire, may result in praise, glory, and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ."
Mm.
Which shows you're going through a trial now, but it's going to prove that you have faith in God, because you're going to trust in Him. And then at the end of this, we get to be with Jesus forever.
Mm.
So there's always going to be that,
yes,
you know,
yeah,
silver lining,
yes,
every trial.
Absolutely. And that's so good, because yeah, that's the end. That's what we get. We're so thankful, because we know whatever we go through here, we know what the end is, right? When we're walking with the Lord. So that's something to just always be thankful for, right? And even when we're having a hard time, because sometimes it is, we're in a rut and we're having a hard time thinking about things that might be, we might be thankful for. It might feel like there's not a lot to give thankful for right around us. You look to the Bible, and we can give thanks for all the promises that He'll never leave us or forsake us, that we get to spend eternity with Him. So you search Scripture, and you can certainly find things to be thankful for, right? Because God's Word is true, and we can always count on that. So, hi.
Hi.
How are you guys?
We're hanging in there.
Yeah. Oh, nice to see you. Okay. Okay. So, we know we got to be thankful, but when we become discouraged, what happens? What happens to our flesh? Right? Our flesh, our emotions, right? Our reaction is that our flesh wants us to become ungrateful, right? Maybe we were super thankful because we got the job, or we, you know, got our way. We had our favorite dinner, or our friends picked us for a team. And then what happens? We lose the job, right? Or we don't get picked, or a friend is unkind. And then we think, well, this stinks. Everything stinks, right? Our flesh, the enemy, wants us to start focusing on all the things we're actually not thankful for, all the things that are going wrong, right? And it happens fast. I don't know if any of you guys have ever experienced that, but it can happen. The enemy will hit you fast, right? With a thought like, well, you deserved that. You did better. You deserved to have that. That's not fair, right? Anybody ever thought that? Not fair. Some things aren't fair, right? A lot of things aren't fair, right? So, and then when we're ungrateful, when our heart and our mind is just like, ah, that stinks, then we start complaining, right? And the Bible refers to as murmuring and complaining. What happens? What's murmuring? Anybody know what murmuring is? Do you know?
Like kind of like mumbling.
Yeah. Yeah, just mumbling like, oh, sucks, or, you know, whatever. Just mumbling, complaining, just being negative. Anybody ever been around somebody that's super negative?
No.
Is it fun?
No.
No, right? No. I've been the negative person. I'm sure people didn't want to be around me. So we become ungrateful, we murmur and complain, and then what happens? The enemy will come and just pluck out all of the things that we have to be thankful for. It's like we forget, right? It's like we have this block, right? And that's what Satan does to us. He'll block all those things. We forget about all that we have to be thankful for. And I want to share a story with you guys. We had a family member, or an extended family member, that in the past we had this experience that we would do, Mike and I would do lots of wonderful things for. We would help so many times, and we were so glad to do it. We might help 15, 20, 30 times, and then the one time we said, I'm sorry, we can't help you with that. They were so angry, and they said, you guys don't care, you don't love me, you don't want to help, right? Anybody else experience that? It's like all those good things get flushed down the toilet instead of just being thankful and saying, okay, well, thanks anyways, right? So what happens then? We get depleted. When you're in a negative, when you're ungrateful and you're not feeling thankful and you're murmuring and complaining, it's like a gas tank. I found this. It's like you go all the way from full to E, right? You just feel exhausted and irritated, right? Anybody ever felt like that?
Quench the Holy Spirit.
Yeah, right. Yeah. So we've already established who does not like when we're thankful. Who does not want us to be thankful the most?
Dad.
Yeah. Yeah. Satan, right? Yeah, he doesn't like that. Because he knows when we're ungrateful and we're not thankful, that's an invitation for him, right? He's like, ah, ha, ha, got him. I'm going to start making him feel negative and all those kinds of things. So when we become discouraged, we become depleted, right? We just feel exhausted. We're tired. We're tired physically. We're tired spiritually. We run out of gas, and then we can't fight. We can't fight. So being ungrateful is an opening or an invitation for the enemy to bully us. That's what he likes to do, right? He's a bully, number one bully. When that will be an open door to let some of those spirits in, right? Yeah, that's how he works. So when we get drained, we become weary, discouraged. It's an opening that the enemy is waiting for. And he tries to hit us when we're down, right? Talk about not fair. He doesn't play fair. All right. And I'm telling you, this is easy to slip into. So what can we do? And it happens to us all. But the goal is we need to try and catch that quickly. And a lot of times you hear people talk about mind renewal or catching those negative thoughts. And that's what it is. It's like, wait a minute. I'm not feeling good right now. And I know that's not from God, right? So you got to switch that around and be focusing on what you're thankful for. Okay. So being thankful, when we are walking in that and we're walking that out, even if it's really, really hard to do, it takes the focus off of us and our circumstances, which might not always be the best, right? And onto the goodness of God, that we can focus, like we said, on those promises that are in the Bible and that how much God loves us. And then what happens? We go from E, we get filled back up, right? We start to experience more joy. We're like, oh, okay. We just get to see, we can see better. We can see clearer the good things around us. So when we choose, because being thankful is a choice, right? Yeah. When we choose to be thankful, we can be filled up and experience God's love and joy that he has for us. And guess what that does then to the enemy? Weakens him, right? He gets a little nervous. He's like, oh, shoot. They're on to me. Another good verse, Colossians 4, verse 2, continue earnestly in prayer, being vigilant in it with thanksgiving. And the reason I put this one on there is when we were talking about, you know, the enemy kind of watching and waiting for us to get weary and start being ungrateful. That's why we need to be vigilant, right? We need to be vigilant how he's trying to attack us and really continue and focus on being thankful. Start each day with a grateful heart, right? That's I've tried to tell my own daughters that, like, before you get out of bed, because sometimes we're laying in bed at night and we start to think about, oh, I got to do this tomorrow, I got this test, or what if they don't like me, or what if they say this? And we have to catch those thoughts, right? And so in the morning, we know how we start our day is really important, right? So if we start our day saying, thank you, Lord. Thank you for waking up. Thank you for breath in our lungs. Thank you that I have a house, a bed, my dog, my cat, whatever it might be, that I get to go down and breakfast. All those things. It just puts us in our heart in a good posture, right? To just start off with in a good way. It can shift the way we think and the way we view the world around us, because there's a lot of cruddy stuff, right? That's easy for us to get bogged down. So being thankful and just focusing on that just helps us to view things differently, right? And I actually want to share something. I have a daughter who is 13, so a little bit closer to you. But And we have tried to focus on, she is, you know, dealing with some hard things at school sometimes. And we've had a revelation, and Erica's worked with her and helped her with this, but about even giving thanks for the people that are kind of bullying her, which is, how do you do that? Right, we try and think of something good about them, right? Something positive, something we're thankful for, right, with them. And she was able to just, she even thought of it was something little, but it shifted her mind, and she was thankful that this girl had helped her. She was really smart at a certain subject, and they had worked together and got a really good grade on a test. So that was a something that just kind of got her mind off of the negative of that girl and was able to just go in with a little more thanksgiving. So the way we start our day, right? If we're having a really crummy day, maybe ahead at work, we think, or we still need to give thanks. Thank you, Lord, that I have a job to go to, right? I even had a circumstance the last couple weeks where things have been really busy and some challenges. And we need to give thanks for things, for everything around us, the Bible says, right? So I would say, well, thank you, Lord, that I have a house to clean. And thank you, Lord, that I have food to cook. And thank you, Lord, that I have kids that I get to drive to the sports and pick up at school and help with homework. And I'll, thank you, Lord, that I have a house that I get to clean up all the messes, right? So that does, it shifts our views, right? And I will also tell you, there's power in verbalizing those things, right? Not just in our mind, but saying those things out loud is really strong, and also shows people around us. We set a good example. So I have a little video that I want to share with you guys, and it's about a story in the Bible. And it's most of you have probably read it. Jesus is, I believe, on his way to Jerusalem, and he encounters 10 lepers. Anybody know what lepers were? Yeah, really, really sick people, right? That nobody wanted to be around. They were fearful. And the story, we'll watch it. It kind of goes that he heals them, right? And let's see what happens.
This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. Jesus did many amazing things while he was on earth.
It's true.
One day, he was traveling to Jerusalem and was going through a village when 10 men who had leprosy came to him. Now, in the time Jesus lived, leprosy was a terrible sickness that could be caught very easily. Because of this, people with leprosy were sent outside of the places that they lived. They were called unclean, and no one wanted to be close to them. But when these men who had leprosy saw Jesus coming,
hey, Jesus,
they called out to him and said, Jesus, have mercy on us. And Jesus saw them and said, go show yourself to the priests.
Oh, yeah, me and that.
And as they went, they were healed and had leprosy no more.
Oh, woo-hoo!
When one of the men saw that he was healed, he came back to Jesus, shouting, praise God.
Oh yeah, praise God.
He thanked Jesus for what he had done.
Aww.
Jesus asked, didn't I heal 10 men? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give glory to God except this Samaritan?
Look, Walker.
Then Jesus said to the man, stand up and go. Your faith has healed you.
Thank you.
And so the man was healed because he had faith and he was thankful for what Jesus had done for him.
Yay. I like how he walked, you know, like pretty cool. That's how I walk when I get healed too, right? Okay. I'll go back here. Oh, we gotta click through these again, right? Earn a man. All right.
You got your app at the
bottom. Oh, okay. There we go. Okay. Slideshow. We'll click back through. So, what'd you guys get out of that one? What'd you guys pick up? Yeah, be thankful for everything. So these guys, it seemed like all 10 of them might have been like, oh, okay, we need to be healed. We need to be healed. Jesus, heal us, heal us, heal us, heal us. And then guess what? He healed them. And then guess what?
Yeah.
So many of them were like, all right, thanks. See ya. Right? Well, actually, they didn't even say thanks. They just went on their way. Right? And then they probably moved on to the next thing. Right? They forgot. And you know what I actually like about that video? It showed that that one Samaritan that came back, he had little tears in his eyes. And then he was so, he thought, whoa, he realized what Jesus had done for him. So he needed to go back. What was his natural response? Was to say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And he wanted to testify and share, right? Go ahead.
I was going to say, another thought that comes to mind is how, like, people profess to believe, but they don't really pray and seek God's face until they go through some type of calamity. And then when you're going through, they're praying, but then when they get a breakthrough, or let's say you do get the job and you're prosperous again and you're not struggling, they go back to not really praying, not really seeking God until something happens again.
Yes.
So I think the key is like continuing to have a consistent prayer life and gratitude and working with the Lord so that when something does come along, it's like you already have that relationship.
Yes.
It's just coming when you need something and stopping. So it's like the other nine, their heart posture wasn't right.
Mm-hmm.
Like they were probably living sinful lives. This happened to them. They were like, okay, we're fixed. Let's just go back to doing what we're doing. But, like, you know, it's kind of like many are called, but few are chosen.
Yeah.
So it's like that one is a representation of chosen. Like, he understood what had happened. His life was changed.
Yeah.
And
amen.
And hopefully going forward, he would obviously pursue to have that relationship with God.
Amen. Thank you for sharing that. That's so important. And when we shared the scripture earlier about praying, like you had mentioned, praying continually, not just coming to God. You know, he hears all our prayers and he cares, but not just coming when things are going bad, right? We need to be praising and praying and thanking when things are going really good and when they're not going so good, right? Because we know we need to prepare. There's seasons, right? And there's hills and there's valleys, and we need to build up that faith, right? We need to, God honors that. And so you're right. And so many of us, I've been guilty of this so many times in my life. Boy, you know, there's a big challenge up ahead and it's you're feeling really connected with the Lord and you feel like you're praying and you're praying for this thing. And then there's breakthrough or you get that prayer answered. And then that's what the enemy does, right? He'll just steal that from us. It's like this blindness. We forget. Then we wake up the next day and we're just on to the next thing. So it is so important for us to stop and spend time reflecting on what all the good things that God has done for us, just reminders, right? And it's actually a great idea. I haven't done such a great job at this recently, but I was journaling all the prayers I had and how God answered them, right? The things that we should give thanks for, the little things. So that's such a good reminder. It's like we get a prayer answered or there's some resolution and then we're just quick to just move on.
Yeah, we used to be at a church where a lady said that they wrote down all their prayers for their family for a full year and God answered every single one of their prayers.
Wow.
And they explained it to the whole group and it was like, okay, well, everybody should be doing that, right? I mean, we should be giving thanks twice as much as we are praying.
So, that's good.
And when we put things in perspective, then when we stop and think, oh, well, maybe this, you know, this day didn't go as quite as we wanted. But then we think about, wow, thank you for healing me of this and doing this and answering this prayer. And it puts things in perspective a little bit, right? So being thankful, this is what I mentioned before, is a choice, right? We are not always, if we're waiting till we feel like being thankful, we're going to be waiting around, right? So we need to make a choice, right? And the Holy Spirit helps us do that. We need to make a choice to give thanks, okay? It is, remember, it's our response to who God is, to his goodness, to his promises, to his love for us. So we don't have to wait to feel thankful to be thankful, okay? Because there are going to be times where we're challenged or we're not feeling like we want to be thankful, but we still have to make a choice to do that, right? And when we're doing these things and we have these actions and we're showing this to people around us, that shows we're showing people that we're walking out being Christ-like, right? That we're followers of Jesus by setting an example to do this. So it's to God. Today we talked a lot about thankfulness to God, but we really are expected to walk that out in showing thankfulness for others too, right? It's important to tell people. It's important to tell our parents and our kids and our coworkers and our friends how thankful we are, right?
Right.
Yeah. That's all I got.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
Amen.
Anybody have any last thoughts or questions or anything about thankfulness or anything else they want to share?
I do.
Yeah, go ahead, Angelo.
I thank God because soon's my birthday coming up.
Awesome. Thank you, Lord. Yeah, that's a great blessing, right? That's awesome. How old are you going to be?
6.
Yes. Wow. 6 is fun. That's awesome. Yeah, thank you, Jesus. We're going to say something?
Yeah, I was just going to add, something that goes with thankfulness, and this is just personally, with the trials that I've been going through, is, thankfulness should kind of go with, praising God.
Mm.
And I was thinking, as I was watching it, is that God inhabits the praises of his people.
Mm.
And if you think about it, evil spirits, they like to be in environments where there's anger, mm. negativity, that literally draws them.
Mm-hmm.
But God is drawn, and even the holy angels are drawn by praise and worship and creating that environment. So it's like if we're thankful and we're praising him, we're worshiping him, even if you don't feel thankful, if you begin mm-hmm. to worship God, you begin to feel joy and happiness. And it's
yes.
The Holy Spirit reminds you of what to be thankful of. So
absolutely.
Kind of what you were saying, we can't just wait around to be thankful, but we have mm-hmm. to take initiative and just worship him and praise him anyway.
Yes.
In the midst of everything, like you said, even if she's being bullied, just praise him anyway.
Amen.
And eventually, once the enemy realizes that he can't change and control your mood by the actions around, it's like, well, let's just stop.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Resist the devil and he'll flee, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Doesn't mean he'll stop looking for opportunities to bully you, but
yeah.
it does. It weakens that. So, yeah, there's power. And when we're feeling kind of crummy, to just putting on worship music or just getting, spending time on our face, praying to the Lord and getting in the Word and stuff, right? Being around, joining others in worship and getting around brothers and sisters in Christ and praying. And yeah, thank you. That's all great.
One other thing that I was thinking of too was that if we're busy thanking God for what he's helped us through, we're less likely to be in it, right? You're not going to be thanking God for something you're still doing.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Lord, that I don't drink anymore.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord, that you delivered me from this.
Yeah.
Constantly giving them thanks for that.
Yeah. Yeah. And giving thanks tears down strongholds, right? It weakens Satan's power. So, go ahead. Do you have something you're thankful for?
How about your mommy?
Or your sister? You have a sister, right? Are you thankful for her? Yeah? Yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah, and last time I saw something scary. I was scared yesterday and I said it was cricket.
Okay, this is time for Sam to
get
thankful about.
Well, and we're going to, what we're going to do. So now we'd like to spend a little time. I have some friends here that are really thankful that you're here. We're all thankful that you're here. And we're thankful that God has helped us and delivered us, right? And so we're here to come around and pray with you guys and help you guys. So we will just kind of spend a little bit of time coming around and chatting with you and seeing how we can pray for you, okay? So I'm glad you guys were here, and I appreciate all the adults. We get to learn from you guys too, so yeah. All right.